What is up? It is Chris Colgan here with your May Northern Virginia real estate market update. I mean, we are in the month of June already and things have been wild all year. So let's just get right into it. One of the things that just blew my mind, I was reading the other day in the Washington Post that somebody in Chevy Chase, Maryland, in our marketplace, paid over $1 million over asking price for a property in Maryland, all cash, $1 million above list price, if you can believe it. Then the CEO of Redfin went off in a series of tweets just talking about weird market stats. He mentioned our market a couple of times. The one that stood out to me the most was a couple actually offered to name their firstborn child after the home seller. And this house was in Maryland, by the way, and the people didn't take the offer. So that is how crazy this market has been. So let's get into some of the stats. Like, what are we seeing? Like, why is this going on? One of the other things that the CEO of Redfin said in his tweets that I read was that home prices across the United States year over year are up 24%, which to me, that actually makes sense. Our area is about the same there. But you got to remember, you're seeing some high valued areas like California, New York, the state of Washington that are losing people to Florida, Virginia, where we're at, the Carolinas, Texas, of course, all these other places. And they're selling, you know, big time $1 million homes, moving to places like Tennessee, which the average sales price is maybe 200,000. And they're coming for where their average sales price was $1 million. They're working from home and that's driving home prices up. Another crazy stat, the cost to build a new home is up 30%. Due to the rising lumber prices, which are up 300%. So unfortunately, everyone was investing in Bitcoin like myself, like an idiot. We should have been investing in lumber futures, but we messed up. Most builders for the moment have just stalled out on building because if you're building a $500,000 house and you're talking 30%, that's an extra 150 grand in building costs. So you're better off just waiting it out, paying whatever you have on that land and just holding out until things get better. Of course, there's also this labor shortage. So all of that is just causing things to kind of get driven up. But I will tell you, the first couple weeks here in June, things have slowed down a little bit. We're noticing that, of course, you got the high school graduations. We have Virginia opening up some of the COVID restrictions and all that. So that is kind of loosening things up. And I think that's going to be a trend we're going to see as people get less distracted. They are like going back to work. They're not working remotely like permanently. But let's go ahead and get into the stats for the month of May. So let's get into these crazy stats. Like, some of this stuff just blows my mind. Like, I never thought I would see some of these prices, like, unless I was like literally like in Malibu. So Arlington, their average sales price right now is $863,000. Like, they are pushing $1 million. It's gotta be one of the most expensive places in the United States to move. And it's just gonna get worse with Amazon's new headquarters as it gets built. Alexandria right now, they're sitting at $709,000 of an average sales price. Then we get out to Fairfax, the biggest county in Virginia, $732,000. Fairfax obviously has like over 1 million residents or something like that. The housing just like is just all over the place there, but that is obviously just getting more and more expensive to live there as you get closer into DC. Then Loudoun County, which is like the hub of all the technology, the growth, their average sales price is $684,000. Then here, where I always say the legend himself lives, Chris Colgan, as if I don't have a big enough ego, our average sales price is $527,000. And then some of these other areas that I mentioned, I'm just looking at my notes here. Falk here, which always blows my mind, $582,000, because I always say people think that's a cheap area to live for some reason. It's not. Warren County, a lot of people have asked me about that. Actually, a bunch of people wrote me that watch these videos, which I appreciate. They said, hey, can you mention Front Royal, Linden area? The average sales price out there is $348,000. So that's not becoming a cheap place to live like it once was, like as a cheap place to escape to live. It's just the average sales price is getting way up there. And then Stafford County, $455,000, which there's a lot of growth out there, a lot of new stuff going on with hot lands and all that. So as you can tell, the prices continue to rise. I think we're getting to a point where they may slow down some as all these stuff in the virus starts to get lifted. One of the things that really blew my mind too, I'm going to mention from that Redfin CEO, was he said 63% of home buyers have written on a home they haven't seen before. To me, that's also not very surprising. Like, if you look at like That's why, you honestly, like, you want a good listing agent. Like, obviously, like, I'm going to plug myself here. But, like, we do video. We do high-end pictures. We do, I hire a professional writer. So, like, think about that. 63% of homebuyers are willing to write on a house without even seeing it. They're seeing just the photos online. So, that is why, like, marketing with an agent is still key. You got to have video. You got to have a great description. You got to have quick-hitting 30-second TikTok videos. Some people go crazy, like, Chris, why do you make those videos? And then I look down and it has 100,000 views on one of my things. That's what people in their 20s that make good money, that's what they watch. You know, they want 30-second stuff. So that, to me, doesn't surprise me. There is an addendum that helps protect everybody I've seen. So you can still get an inspection and all that. But you are saying, yeah, I'm writing an offer without seeing the house. So at the end of the day, where do we go from here? If you're thinking about buying a house, I always tell people, wait. If you're thinking, hey, you know what, I want to buy a place, live there for 2 years and then sell it and make a bunch of money, that's not going to happen. Like, I always tell people, only buy something if you're looking to stay there for 5 to 7 years. Like, don't think of it as a short-term thing. If you're only going to stay in this area for a year or two or anywhere for a short amount of time, just rent. But if you have any questions, feel free to shoot me. We'll put my number here at the bottom. Shoot me a text. Hit me up anytime with any of your real estate questions. Like, subscribe, comment, whether you're watching this on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. I appreciate all the new subscribers. As always, I will see you at the top or from the top.